Triston, one point on the board already. Immense effort by the Trinidad and Tobago team in the first game against Mexico. Go through it for us.
Well, for us, you know, it took a lot of hard work and communication and dedication to, you know, go out and defend for 90 plus minutes against, you know, the 11th best place team in the world. So, you know, going into the game, we was focused, you know, and we just carry out what the coach wanted, and we did our best, played our hearts out.
What was it like for you out there in the environment, playing before 40,000 plus?
Well, you know, I try to blank out, you know, most of the game and what they had to say on the outside and focus on the inside, because, you know, that could be a big part of your game to discourage you, because the fans, you know, was against us, and I just kept my mind right.
What was it like for you, you know, being injured for a few months out of the national team picture and coming back into the team, having a really good game in the first match against Montserrat and then injured out, and then coming into the squad again for this Mexico clash? So let's go through that for us.
Oh, well, injury is a hell of a thing, I must say, but the most important thing is your therapy. You know, once you take your therapy the right way, you know, things will work out. And I always believe in myself and in my ability that I can play against anybody, and, you know, it's proven.
Now we have two games left in the group phase, El Salvador on Wednesday. A victory here could put us in the driver's seat to qualify for the second phase. What do you make of it, and what's the mood like in the camp?
The mood in the camp, you know, we have a lot of confidence, and I think that we will beat El Salvador if we do everything that the coach wants us to do and we stick with the game plan. We will come out victorious. My name is Triston Hodge, defender for Trinidad and Tobago, and I represent QRP. For me, it means a lot to me, because at a young age, you know, I always wanted to be a footballer, and I always wanted to represent my country, and at the under 17 level, you know, I didn't really make the team, you know, I was cut, and I just never gave up, and now I'm here with the senior team, and it's an honor, and I feel very good. And I hope, like, you know, the youths out there, you know, could not give up very easily, and they could push you, because things happen that words can't explain, and, you know, you just continue to do your thing and your chance will come.